Joined now by Fox NFL analyst LeVar Arrington and Mark Slare. Stinky, so let's start with you. Did Cam silence his doubters last night?
Well, I don't think he silenced his doubters. I mean, there's still going to be doubters, but, I mean, he acquitted himself pretty well, although it was against the Jets. So I think we have to be careful about saying, you know, we're silencing doubters. They are the Jets. But, you know, to finish the game without a turnover, to complete 70, you know, almost 80% of your passes, to do all those things that he did, that's a great start. The thing I like most about that is not silencing your doubters. It's taking responsibility for the way you've played. And I think you have to do that. And that shows some maturity that maybe in the past that Cam Newton wasn't willing to show. But that's the part about Cam Newton that I really appreciate. Man, I haven't played well enough. I've been the one that made the mistakes. I've been the one that has let my teammates down. And you know, to focus on those things, that's how you grow. That's how you get better. That's how you, you know, are accountable for and take responsibility for where you are right now. So I think that part was good, but the doubters are still going to be there because you won against the Jets.
And that's the problem I have with it. Look, the critics aren't going to be silenced by this because they're going to continue to move the goalposts. As you say right there, Mark, it's funny when you have individual success, they say, well, how'd the team do? And then when you have team success, they say, well, who'd you play against? And they just keep moving the goalposts to a point where Cam Newton, in a losing effort but a great individual performance against Seattle, we're singing his praises. And then he actually has a good performance and he wins the ball game, but it's against the Jets. So then now everyone has an issue with it. It just doesn't make any sense in that respect. If you're going to be an evaluator, you have to look at performance, even extracting that from actual winning and losing. So Cam Newton is trending in the right direction. Those doubters out there that are saying, oh, but who'd you play against? Oh, but what about the team success? Are really getting lost in the conversation. The conversation is first, Cam Newton. Cam Newton getting successful plays. Cam Newton feeling comfortable in his system. Cam Newton getting acclimated to this culture. I see that, LeVar, trending upward.
Yeah, I don't think it was enough of a game to silence the doubters, as you both had mentioned. But I will say this. Why put doubt at the feet of Cam Newton, right? Solely. This is a depleted offensive team. This is a depleted defensive team of guys that have opted out on the year, on the season. This is a team that's trying to find its way with so many question marks. You had the departure of, the greatest player of all time in the history of the sport. So to look at Cam and solely say, I doubt you, Cam, based off of where this team currently is, or if you're looking at how he has played, I think that it's unjust. I don't think that it is rightly placed. And I will also add to this, if he is able to carry, which it will be his effort that would lead to them being able to win this upcoming game against the Ravens, then the doubters really do have to fall all the way back on how they're viewing Cam Newton.
Yes, it's unfortunate that Cam is in a situation where he's dressing up, putting lipstick on this pig, dressing up this sorry team that we all knew that wasn't going to be much. That's the same reason Tom Brady left this team. He left because he was like, nah, I am not going down with this ship. You guys are going to damage my reputation, damage my resume, damage my legacy by going out there with this depleted receiving core. Cam Newton last night completed 18 passes to undrafted wide receivers, which is the most in a Super Bowl era with a winning performance. Like, Cam Newton is playing with guys we've never heard of, we've never seen. And that was one of the things that was a positive for Tom Brady. He could turn a no-name into a household name. But when Cam Newton does it, all of a sudden we move the conversation just a little more and start to say, hey, who'd he play against? Or, hey, well, he's not looking amazing as a dual threat. Not exactly what we expected. Stink, to me, is just a conversation where people don't look like they ever want to be satisfied if you're talking about Cam Newton.
Well, yeah, I mean, I think there's part of that. And I think some of that, you know, goes back to when you watch him and the kind of MVP performance he had throughout the course of his career and in 2015, you know, a different style of football. Obviously, he was a physical freak. He was completely gifted. And then, you know, there was issues with the intermediate passing game and some of those things that he was able to overcome. In 2018, for about 9 games, he was exceptional throwing the football. But we don't put that on him, right? That was the outlier. That was the anomaly, right? And we want to see that. But you're 100% right. I mean, ultimately, the thing I love is Cam Newton will say, hey, man, I sucked. Like, I wasn't good enough, and I'll move on, and I'll be okay with that. There are some guys that we will never give the credit to, and he seems to be one of those guys, and that's okay. I don't think it bothers him. I think he's just going out there playing for himself, playing for the opportunity to see where he lands next year and to see how he can revitalize his career after 2 years of being, you know, of being injured. Here's the crazy thing, right? We keep talking about, and I've met with the Buccaneers. I've done 3 Buccaneers games. I've met with Tom Brady and say, hey, new offense, new system, new this, new that, new receivers, trying to figure it out. Those are all legitimate, right? New offense, new terminology. They're all legitimate. And I'll give that to Tom Brady. But you know what I'm also willing to do? I'm also willing to give that to Cam Newton because it's true. It's hard to do those things. But we don't ever talk about that with Cam, right? We expect him to go out there and run around and do the things he does and, you know, and put the team on his back and carry him. And you're 100% right, Marcellus. There's a reason Tom Brady left New England. It was because, and I don't have the weaponry here and the players here to really compete at a high enough level. I'm going somewhere else.
Yeah, I mean, you know, it's crazy. They don't have any margin of error. Like, that's the problem with this team right now. They 3-0 when they win a turnover battle, 0-5 when they don't. It's just that simple because you don't have any room for error. And Tom Brady realized that, whether he was in decline or not. He just realized, these guys will never inflate me. I always have to do the inflating around here. And Cam Newton finds himself in a position where he can say, yeah, I'm going to own up to my issues. I'm going to own up to the fact that I have not been playing perfect football. But at the same time, I have to do my job and start to look around Cam Newton. I pointed out the receiving core issues. Let's point out the defensive issues. How about the fact that they're giving up 24 points a game? That's the most points a game allowed during the Belichick era. How about 137 rushing yards per game? That's the most rushing yards in a Belichick era. So even Tom Brady will find some difficulty winning when the defense is not performing up to standard. Cam Newton has had his issues, but the other side of the ball has had his issues as well.
You know, if we're being real about this, fellas, Cam Newton's doubters are not purely basing their hate and their doubt and their vitriol towards Cam based off of football-related things.
Uh-oh.
Cam is a good-looking dude. If this was like the rocket, if this was rock and roll, he'd be Lenny Kravitz. Lenny Kravitz just turned like 80 years old, and he looks like he's 20.
Yeah, he's
abs. He looks real good. He went out there. I wish I could be Lenny Kravitz if I was a man. He isn't that old. I'm just making a joke.
Stupid.
But Cam is that guy that everybody, like, you will look at, and you're going to measure yourself off of Cam. And you're not going to measure yourself off of how well he plays. You're going to measure yourself off of, man, like, do I look like that? Like, am I tall like that? No, you're not. You're not any of those things that Cam is checking off on the box. Cam is that guy that you wish, like, is that going to be my child as he grows up? Now, Stink, I know you've done well. You got great gene pool going with yourself there, Marcellus. But if we could both say, if I could write up and draw up in my wish box and my dream of what I want my kid to look like and be like, it'd be Cam, right? So that's where all of this hate is really coming from.
Oh, really?
From.
Cam, all the hate comes Cam from looks, him not looking like you, but looking like Lenny Kravitz. What the hell?
Yes! He looks the part after the games. He fits the mold. Like, look at – did y'all see
nobody
his – look at his post.
Nobody cares – how you look, unless it's between the white lines. That dictates how they're going to evaluate you outside of that.
Line up all them doubters. Let's see what they look like.
Hey, no.
Let's see what they look like physically.
Line up the top 10 quarterbacks in NFL history and then look at them. That's my point. Ain't nobody tripping on how you look. Not all of those guys at GQ. Not all of those guys at GQ. Look, Cam Newton has never been more accurate. Forget about how good he looks. It's the fact that he's never been this accurate. This is a career high for him in completion percentage. 68.1 completion percentage. This is a guy you can build around once he gets comfortable in the offense. And we've been seeing him post-COVID last couple of weeks start to get more comfortable in the offense. You can't put it all on Cam Newton because Belichick didn't get his hands on Cam Newton till June 28th when he signed him. Then he signs him. He comes in late. Everything's virtual. You got a compromised training camp. And then you give him a plethora of undrafted wide receivers. Look at his top 3 targets this year, y'all. Crazy. Damir Bird, undrafted law firm Jacobian Myers, and then a 34-year-old post-steroid Julian Edelman. That's who Cam Newton is playing with right now. It just is amazing that he won't get even a little bump of consideration or respect because of the assets or the lack thereof around him.
Well, to your point, on Monday Night Football, they put a graphic up, I believe, that I saw that said Bill Belichick hasn't drafted a Pro Bowl player since 2013. I believe the Kansas City Chiefs have drafted 9 Pro Bowl players since 2013. So, you know, I mean, the thing you love about football is it's a complete team game. And I think the thing I love is the complementary nature. Like, I can't be good at my job unless we as an offensive line are all good. We can't be good as an offense unless all 11 guys are connected. We can't really have explosive run game or run plays unless the wide receivers are willing to block. And the wide receivers can't catch a ball unless everybody's willing to do their job. And if we stink on the offensive side and turn the ball over, guess what? You're going to give up a lot of points on the defensive side. Mm-hmm. So I love the aspect of complementary football and the way it all ties together. That's why it's the ultimate team sport. And if you haven't drafted a Pro Bowl player since 2013, then Bill Belichick, the general manager, is letting down Bill Belichick, the head coach.
I love what you're saying there, Stink. And that it ties back to what I was saying. You may want to say it has nothing to do with looks.
What, looks?
But it has everything to do with the perceived arrogance of what people think Cam Newton is. Huh. It's the way Cam carries himself, the way he does his interviews, the way he speaks on things. People look at it, and that what you just said, Stink, it plays a part. Can we honestly sit here and confidently say that we feel that that continuity exists all the times with Cam and his relationship between his unit, within his receiving core, within the defense, the whole team dynamic? Sometimes you look at it and you have this preconceived notion of what you feel you think he is, and that's probably the furthest thing from reality and the truth, but that perceived arrogance, that perceived look, the way he looks after games, the way he looks on the field, people doubt him and people put extra weight on Cam because of those preconceived, inaccurate notions of who they think he is.
That's interesting you say that, because in a situation where you have Belichick and his dynasty, and will he be able to resurrect it this year or going forward, he becomes Teflon in the conversation of issues, as Stink was talking about. The fact that they haven't drafted Pro Bowl players of late, the fact that the defense is not playing up to standard. You can hear those numbers, you can see those statistics, and you still won't point directly at Bill Belichick because of all the rings and all the success. Mm-hmm. But then you look at Cam Newton and you're like, yeah, he's a former MVP, but of late he's been injured, he hasn't been consistent, and you got to go back a couple years for only a fraction of a season to see any form of that greatness. So it's amazing that when you have that tug of war, that seesaw effect, you don't look at Belichick with the issues. You look at Cam Newton. He's the scapegoat. He's the easier target to poke at. But if you start to dive a little deeper into the numbers, you can see them trending upward for Cam Newton. What Cam Newton needs is what Cam Newton's going to get next week. You need to have a great individual performance, a winning performance, and you need to do it against a formidable opponent. They play the Baltimore Ravens next week. He can answer every question about his game going forward if he has this type of performance and they get a W against the Ravens. We're going to see if that happens, and we're going to see if the critics have something to say after that game.